Good morning! Thank you for joining day 39 of 100 days of 10 minute crochet. If you don't know what we are doing in this video, please read the information in the description below. There you can also find the link to the written pattern of this amigurumi we are making. Today we continue with the assembly and we start with the ear, the second ear actually. Yesterday we attached this ear. And today I will show you again how to do this. So grab your ear. So if you have it like this, then fold it and fold it in such a way that your yarn end is at one of the ends of the ear. And then just push it in a little, fold it and flatten it out. You can see these pins here. That is approximately between where I will be placing the ear. So that's between row 2 and row 30. So if you haven't done so, go ahead and place those pins so you know where your edges of your ear are supposed to be. And also make sure they are on the same line from this tip to this tip. And then to the same tips of the other ear, so that should be one line, one straight line. So between this and the other pin. And then pin the middle. So first pin the edges and then the middle. And then check if everything is on the same spot as the other ear. So we can see that this bulge of the ear is on the same line. So that's good. And these edges are also on the same place. And then we can check from the front. So we can see where this lines up with the eye. That's also where this ear lines up with the eye. So that's it's perfect. We can get rid of these extra pins. I'll use them to pin here. Some extra pins can never hurt. Just like we did yesterday, we go through one stitch here. Can you see it? Yeah, you can see it now. And then, because we folded the ear, you need to go through the stitches of one side and through the stitches of the other side that are now together. So now we go underneath and then we go through the stitches of the other side. And then, so let's see, make a straight line. And then go underneath a stitch of the head and pull through. And then go underneath two loops of one side, and then on the exact opposite side, go underneath the other two loops. My pin is in the way. If your pin is in the way, just get it out because you have more pins that will hold the ear down. And also make sure this doesn't happen. The yellow pin was holding the yarn. So I went underneath two V stitches, two V loops. And then I'm going underneath the ear and through the head. No, I went under two stitches of the head. That's not very nice. You just need to go underneath one stitch, because else you will see all the stitches coming out of the head. You don't want it here at the back. It's fine. There's nothing you can do about it, but you can prevent the stitches from these lines from coming out of the head. You can prevent it on this side by being as close to the ear as possible when you're stitching. So continue doing this along the whole ear. Up by going through the head, so you cannot see the thread going up again, because I want this to be a little more closer to the head. So always check your ears if they are correctly attached. Hide the yarn tail. And just shape the ear a little bit. I think it's so colorful with the pink and purple and the green, and there's still yellow and beige coming for the nose. And also whiskers, we will also still be making whiskers, so that will all come eventually during the assembly. Today we are finished. Tomorrow I'll show you how to attach the feet. So they will come somewhere here and here. The tail. And then of course the collar. Where the little bell, I don't have it with me now, but the tiny little bell, and also the nose and the whiskers. Okay, so that is it for today. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more cute crochet. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.